ATEZR sent me the V35 and asked me to test it out and tell you guys what I think about it. Before we get started, ATEZR did send me this laser for free. They did ask me to give an honest review of this laser, and that's what I plan to do, to give you my honest opinion, to let you have the knowledge you need to purchase or not purchase this laser. The V35 is an upgrade to the P20 laser. It has the same base. The only thing different is the laser head and the harness. So they have a long row to hoe with me because I am extremely happy with my P20. And I'm about to take off that laser head and harness and redo it with the V35 that they sent me. So let's quickly compare the P20 laser head to the V35.
Holy moly, look at the size difference in this sucker.
Before you jump up saying, I've gotta have it, know that you need to know what you need for your business. If you're just needing to engrave stuff, you don't need a V35. You need something more like a 5 or 10 watt laser, and that'll do for you. This laser can cut through a 2x4. An engrave and a cut test are the best ways to figure out what you need to do on what material. So that's what we're gonna do today. We're gonna do a lot of cutting and a lot of engraving today on a lot of different materials. But first, we're gonna start off with some 3mm plywood. I'll come back and let you know what I think.
So I don't think that there's a need to test out the entire system and me tell you what I think about a system I've already given you a review on. You know I love my ATEZR.
Results from the engraving right there. Not bad. And here are the cut settings. They're fairly inconsistent. I would figure a 35 watt would have cut all of these out pretty much, but it did not. You can see the ones that are still there. I just don't know what to say. It has to be a setting because this is a 35 watt laser compared to a 20 watt laser that cut a lot better than that. One of the best ways to figure out if your belts are all tight and everything's on track is to cut out a circle. I have some 5mm ply. I'm gonna cut a circle out of that and see how it works. There we go. That is the circle there. And it cut very nicely without any adjustment to the belts or anything like that. And there's minimal charring on the outside. I think I found a good setting for this right there. I don't use acrylic very often because I don't like the smell of it. It gets in the shop and it stays there. But I am going to engrave a small Grinch on a keychain and cut it out and see how well this 35 watt laser does it. I do a lot of laser work on dog tags, so let's see if we can do an engrave test on this or a marking test and see how it looks on there so I can get the settings I need to start doing some more of that.
All right, so there it is. It doesn't have the numbers on it, but I got it written down on a piece of paper that'll go with this, and I'll be able to use this to do engravings on dog tags.
So something else I do a lot of are these little anodized keychains, and I put little sayings on there. So let's check and see if it engraves well on that, because I know my P20 doesn't do great with this one. So I still gotta figure out how to line it up a little bit better. It's hard to see, but yeah, that came out really good. I see a lot of people doing slate coasters. I do a few of them. Let's give that a test so I can have the settings for engraving on coasters. Well, here's the results for the slate. I do a few flasks here and there for presents for people or just for gifts for other people to give to other people. So let's go ahead and do a test engrave on there so I can find the settings for that.
But remember to always fill these with water, because if not, they may buckle. I've had a couple do that without the water in it.
right there. Look at the colors on that. It did very well.
So now we're going to do an engraving on painted tile. This has blue, red, and yellow paint underneath it. And we're going to do an engraving test to see what we need to do to be able to engrave a picture on it. And here it is, the results for the painted tile. You make your decision on these cuts when you do them on your own tiles. I know what I'm going to use for this one.
All right, I'm done doing the testing, and it's time for us to buckle in, because it's time to tell you about the good, the bad, and the ugly. Look, I feel that it's a very personal decision whether you need to upgrade to the V35. What I'm doing here is I'm doing everything I can to give you the information to make a wise choice. With that being said, let's get into the bad and the ugly.
The engraving. You saw the engraving, there it is. I don't see a major difference between this one and the 20 watt. Like I said, it could be my settings. I don't know, but I have reset light burn and tried it again, and I get the same every single time. So, if you know what I did wrong, or if this is correct, let me know down in the comments below. We can always talk about it and figure out what's going on. I mean, it took less time, it was faster, but yeah, that's just what it is, right? Okay. So another bad that I did not show in the video, but I'm gonna talk about it now, where the air assist goes into the top of the laser. I'll still pick you right up here. I had that and I tried to pull off the hose and it broke off. I don't know if there was a crack in it or what, but when I pulled the hose off, it shouldn't have torn off. Now I fixed it, I used some super glue, and hopefully that'll be fine, but I think that'd be an issue, especially when you spend so much on a laser. Settings. There's not very many of them out there. ATEZR has a few on their website. I believe that they should have done a lot of testing and put all of the testing material on there. That's it. Those are the negatives I found with this laser. Let's move on to what I feel are the good points in this laser. This thing is fast. That is the good thing about a more powerful laser. You can get stuff done quicker, you can batch stuff out faster, and get it out to your clients quicker. The laser head has a clear window so you can see the laser spot when you're trying to set it up. Integrated air assist. I know the 20 watt had it, but a lot of lasers on the market today don't. So I think it's important that I point that out, that it has it, because it's something that I think everyone should have on their lasers, and it's something you need to use while you're lasing on wood. I've used a bunch of my 20 watt lasers to do these little keychains, and I usually have to use my IR fiber laser that I have. And normally a 20 watt laser doesn't leave a very good mark on this, I guess you'd call it, because it's not engraving. But this one, it did. It actually looks really good, and I think I can make a jig for this, and I'd be able to make dozens of these instead of one at a time with my fiber laser. This laser did amazing on this slate, and it was pretty fast too. You could see right, I know I've shown it to you before, but look at it. It looks really good. I want to talk real quickly about the painted tiles. I absolutely suck at this, but I've been working on it and I'm getting a little bit better. You can see I got that skull on there. I have to get my settings down for this. I've got to prep these correctly, but I'm trying. I'm trying to show you things you can do, and there are some people that do amazing work, and I wish I had their skill with the laser, and I wish I could do it, but I can't. I'm trying. I'm getting there. Now, if you need something burned into wood, I'm your man. If you need something cut out of wood, I'm your man. You need a tile done, or a mirror done, or a piece of acrylic done, I'm not your man. Look, I know I didn't show it, but this thing can cut a 2x4. Not really sure when that would be practical, but it's cool to say, hey, I've got a laser that can cut a 2x4.
Be real for a minute. 90% of you don't need to upgrade to a 35 watt laser. A 10 watt or a 20 watt where you're cutting 3 millimeter ply or 5 millimeter ply is just fine for you. You don't need to rush out every time the new biggest and greatest thing comes out. With that being said, if this is your first machine and you're looking to do not just a basic hobby, but something that you can produce work on fast and batch it out and get it out to the customer, this is a good laser. the whole system all together, and I'll put a link down below. I think it's on sale right now. Do I suggest that you abandon your 10 and 20 watt laser? No, I don't suggest you do. But if this is the first machine that you're gonna buy, or you're upgrading your entire system, yeah, this is a good laser. And I know there's 40 watt lasers out there. I'm gonna tell you, I've tested a 40 watt laser and a 35 watt laser, and I didn't see any difference in how they cut.
All right, appreciate you stopping by. Appreciate you hit that thumbs up button, share the video if you could, and if you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. And until next video, stay cool.